Hello everyone, my name is Katarina and today I'm presenting weekly supervised multitask learning for concept-based explainability. Starting with the motivation, I think it's no surprise that deep learning has attained competitive results in various tasks across different domains, and that at the same time has been identified as being very opaque and difficult to understand what it's learning exactly. And even more so, if we think of the humans in the loop, which are often domain experts that lack machine learning knowledge, they struggle to understand these predictions, these model predictions. And although recently some deep learning explainability methods have been proposed, like gradient-based methods, these are still too technical and too low level for these personas. So if we consider here this example on the left, it uses information about the model features, and this is really too low level and difficult to understand by the domain experts. On the other hand, high level concept-based explainability, it is way easier to understand because it provides explanations that use concepts, and these concepts are the way these domain experts reason about a given task. A natural way of providing concept-based explainability is through multitask learning or joint learning of explanations and decision tasks. And we can think of this as a normal feed-forward neural network that has two specialized layers, the explainability layer, which is responsible for outputting the explanations or the concepts, and the decision layer that is responsible for outputting the conventional and traditional decision about a given instance. And we can see here that by design, we have a strict dependency of the decision layer on the explainability task. To train this model, we can use this loss function that uses, and through backpropagation, we can simply train this model. In terms of parameters and data that is used in this architecture, we can see that the first L+1 parameters are shared across the different tasks. We have here this strict dependency of the decision task on the explainability task. And naturally, we have the need for explainability labels or concept labels so that we can train the explainability task. And likewise, we need the decision labels to be able to train the decision task. So what is the problem? Well, our problem is that we have a high resources setting for the decision task. So we have a lot of labels for a lot of transactions for the decision task, but we have low resources for the explainability task. Only a small subset of those transactions are labeled with the explainability labels. And at the same time, we have out-of-the-shelf domain knowledge, which is not being used, and that incurs no further costs. And given this setting, our research question becomes whether we can improve somehow the fully supervised approach that is trained on this low resources baseline. And we identified two main parts of the architecture as being the fulcral points to tackle. So we have the need for explainability labels. We need labels or else we won't be able to improve and the fully supervision approach. And we also need to better explore this dependency here of the decision and on the explainability task. The problems themselves have to do with the label scarcity and how we have insufficient concept labels. And we are all aware of how data hungry these deep learning models are. So to be able to obtain good deep learning generalization, we usually require massive data sets. And at the same time, carrying labeling campaigns to label these data sets is not feasible in many cases. And so that is not an option. On the other hand, we have the multitask learning and how we can effectively explain the model's predictions in a way that the explainability task explains the decision task and reflects the humans in the loop own reasoning. So regarding the proposed solution, we propose to apply a weak supervision technique using the available domain knowledge. And the domain knowledge that we have at hand are high-level domain concepts taxonomy, information left by a rule-based system. And using these two, we can try to combine them in a way that allow us to obtain a massive but noisy explainability data set. And on the other side of the spectrum, we have the exploration of different learning strategies. So now that we have both noisy and golden explainability labels, how can we use this information to try and devise a more effective learning strategy? Regarding the weak supervision technique, we adopted the distant supervision one, and it goes as follows. So we have a set of unlabeled data. So we don't have the concept labels, but we do have the decision labels and the information triggered by a rule-based system. At the same time, we have a spreadsheet with the semantic description of the rules, and we have a concepts taxonomy. Using the information of these two artifacts, we can create this rule to concept mapping that is validated by domain experts. And we use this to programmatically label all this data with the explainability labels. And then we, in the end, we obtain a noisy labeled data set. In terms of the learning strategies, so as I said, we have different qualities of the labels, and we started thinking of whether we could improve the performance on any task by combining these different labels in different ways. And so I'm going here to show you visually what are the learning strategies that we proposed. But before that, I'd like to explain what's going on this picture. So we have here the explainability data, and here we are reflecting the quality of the explainability labels, the golden labels, and the noisy explainability labels. These are going to be combined somehow here in the learning strategies, and we will see that we will use them to define the batches. And these batches are provided to the architecture of the concept-based explainable model that you've seen before. So the first learning strategy that we propose is called two-stage learning. And without surprise, it comprises two stages. The first one, called pre-training, consists of training different models called the base models with only noisy labels. And then after training these noisy models, we can basically fine-tune them using two different types of batches, batches comprising only golden labels, or batches comprising both type quality labels. So here in this case, we are creating batches that contain not only golden labels, but also noisy labels. Finally, we propose the hybrid learning strategy, which simply trains right from the start the model with both quality of the labels. So it simply trains and creates the batches with both noisy and golden labels. To answer our research question, we conducted an experiment. This experiment was done on a payment retailer that wanted to deploy a multitask approach for concept-based explanations. And it comprised a binary decision task, whose goal was to detect fraudulent transactions, and also a multi-level explainability task made of 14 concepts, and whose goal was to output high-level explanation about the model's predictions. Regarding the availability of the label types, we can see that the golden decision has a high availability with around 6 million transactions. The noisy explainability, because it is derived from the same data set as the golden decision labels, has also the same availability. And the golden explainability has a much lower availability with only 1,500 transactions. In terms of the metrics, we use fraud recall at 5% FPR. And we basically set the threshold in validation for 5% FPR, and then use that threshold on a test set to obtain this metric performance. And regarding the explainability task, we use the mean average precision, which consists of obtaining the average precision for each concept for each transaction, and then averaging the results obtained across different transactions. Regarding the model development, we run the same exact hyperparameter grid for each variant, where we vary the number and dimension of hidden layers, the learning rate, and the relative importance of the explainability task with respect to the decision task. And we do this for two random seeds. Here are the results for the two random seeds. we can see that the purple points are the best solutions in a multi-objective setting. So they represent the best compromises in terms of the two objectives. And you can immediately see that this baseline provides a very poor baseline for the decision task, barely reaching the 15% fraud recall. Whereas in the explainability task, we do reach a reasonable results of the MAP performance metric. So we will keep here the range of the best values found so that it is easier to compare the following approaches. A two-stage learning strategy, we, as I've said, train the base models. We run the hyperparameter grid and are going to train every base model using this NYSE level data set. And so here we have the results for the two random seeds. And we can see that the performance in the explainability task degraded significantly. So it was previously 0.54 and now it's 0.30. And that on the other hand, the decision task performance improved by a lot. So previously we had almost 15% fraud recall and now we have almost 80%. So going to the second stage, whose goal was to improve the explainability task without hurting the decision task, we are going to fine tune these base models using golden labels. And to do so, we select the best models of the first stage, the so-called Pareto models. And we are going to run a different grid where we also vary the learning rate, the epochs, and the batch size. We try freezing and unfreezing of layers, and we try different batching techniques. These are the results. And we can see that for the same task performance, so around 0.8 fraud recall, we can significantly improve the explainability task. So previously we had here a value of the explainability task below 30%, and now we have almost the double. Okay, regarding the last strategy, each training batch contains a fraction of the explainability golden labels, and by default in all our experiments use the 10% fraction of golden labels, and we would like obviously to try a different fraction. These are the results for the two random seeds, and we can see that when comparing to the fully supervision approach, the decision task is greatly improved by the hybrid learning strategy, and if we compare the explainability performance of the hybrid with the one from the two-stage base models, it also is able to improve significantly. However, it does seem rather worse than the two-stage with fine-tuning. Joining all these learning strategies on a single plot, we have here the Pareto optimal solutions for each of the models. And we can see that these results seem to be promising, but we still need further experiments with more seeds and more runs to gain statistical confidence. It is possible to jointly learn the decision and associated explanations, and both proposed learning strategies are able to improve the decision at a reduced cost in the explainability task. And we also want to do a more in-depth exploration of the hyperparameter space to understand if we can explore these learning hyperparameters to achieve a better result. As a conclusion, we tackle the problem of concept-based explainability with multitask learning. And in particular, we tackled the problems of label scarcity and joint learning of decision and associated explanations. We propose to use distant supervision and thus use the available off-the-shelf domain knowledge and to use different learning strategies. As a future work, we want to improve the confidence in the results, try different test sets, random seeds and statistical tests for varying the performance. We want to perform a more in-depth exploration of the hyperparameter space and explore the correlations between learning hyperparameters and performance, and also test different hyperparameter optimizers. Here we conducted all our experiments using the grid search. And then we have the need for exploring label denoising strategies such as noisy layers or multiple label sources aggregation. And with this, I conclude my presentation. If you have any questions, let me know. Have a great conference.